Christmas, church!
Merry Christmas!
There we go. We need to say it like we mean it. Say it like it's a part of who we are. Boy, it's just good to be in the house of the Lord this Christmas season, or better, I should say this Advent season, because that's what our youth and children will be telling us about this morning as we proceed in the Sundays of Advent, the joy, the hope, the peace, and love that is available to us through Jesus Christ.
Sprout from David's line. He will do what is just and right in the land. In those days, Judah will be saved and Jerusalem will live in safety. This is the name by which it will be called, the Lord our righteousness.
Come, Isaiah 11, 6-9. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. And he will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Of the increasing of his government and of the peace there will be no end. He will reign on David's throne and over his kingdom, establishing and upholding it with justice and righteousness from that time on and forever. The zeal of the Lord Almighty will accomplish it.
I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord, through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks for answering me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the capstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us rejoice in it.
James for Jesus, our Savior and King. His love and kindness are the reason we sing. Always for others, the people we meet. We'll lead them to Jesus by meeting their needs. Always for you, and though it seems odd, the last will be first in the kingdom of God. I've got the joy, 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 joy down in my heart.
Smiled in wonder, and shepherds stood in awe.
God so loves the world. Do you get it? That his son was given as a ransom for you. See, that's the message of Christmas. It isn't just the tinsel and the gifts and all the hustle and bustle and all the stuff. I think we all admit we got enough stuff. But see, we want some of that. We want some of the real thing that God offers this Advent and Christmas season. You know, the wise men, they went a long ways. They traveled a long way to receive this newborn king. And they went home by another way because their lives were transformed. That's the message. That's the Christmas message for each of us. For God so loved you that he gave his son for you. That if you would just but believe in him, receive him as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords, you would receive him as Savior and Lord. Our scripture says, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, his right relationships, and all the other stuff will be added to you. Not that we're into getting stuff. I want the real thing, and that's the love of God. How about you? Let us pray. Gracious and everlasting God, I thank you, Lord, that you offer us the real deal, that you offer us the spirit of Christmas. It comes to this little package wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. That wood of that manger became the wood of the cross, that we are forgiven. So, Lord God, I would just ask if there's anyone here that wants to receive this gift anew, just want to say, Lord, I want some of that. Just raise your hand. Yeah, I'm not going to point you out. Amen, amen. I'm not going to embarrass you. This is between you and God. Yeah, this is you are at the manger. In your mind, see, you are kneeling at the manger. The Christ child is before you. And God says, you are my beloved child. Receive. Come to my kingdom. Anyone want to receive that this morning? So I want that. Thanks be unto God that the tears that we shed are not tears of sorrow, but they are tears of joy. Joy to the world. The Lord has come. Let earth receive his kingdom. Someone will share the light with me, then my candle will shine. The scripture says, and a child shall lead them. You know, Jesus made it very clear that to such belongs the kingdom of God. Go forth into this world, letting the light of Christ shine through you. Let it shine in the darkness. The darkness may not comprehend it. But those who are seeking, the least, the last, and the lost, will see the light. Not you, but the light of Christ shining within you. That will be an attraction. All men will be drawn unto Jesus Christ as you offer your light unto the world. Go forth now to be and make disciples in Jesus Christ. Let us go forth to let our light shine. Amen.
Amen.